Interfacing with the Mabati Prop Committee of Parliament last week, the Prime Minister of Uganda, Robin Nabanja, recommended that all Karamoja iron sheets which were taken by ministers and other officials be replaced by iron sheets from the Ministry of Northern Uganda Affairs, which still have huge stocks of them in the opium stores.
They should be replaced in a way of obtaining iron sheets from other affirmative ministries, because we sit in the same store. Responsible for those areas where the iron sheets were given. For example, the iron sheets said that were given to the Right Honourable Speaker. The iron sheets that were given to Her Excellency the Vice President. The iron sheets that were given to Honourable Chitutu. Since Northern Uganda still has iron sheets, we can replace them by getting iron sheets from Northern Uganda because they are still there.
However, her proposal has not gone well from members of Parliament from Northern Uganda, who addressed a press conference at Parliament today and asked the Prime Minister to lose appetite on her proposal.
I think this is total madness. We have never seen this kind of madness in this country. The Right Honourable Prime Minister should withdraw a statement immediately. If you look at it critically, Northern Uganda, where we come from, we are still sleeping in grass touch. Karamoja, they sleep in grass touch and houses made of leaves. The two regions, Karamoja and Northern Uganda, are the regions that calls for more iron seats. And the Prime Minister, without confusion, she's saying, let the iron seats from Northern Uganda replace the stolen iron seats by our ministers. I think we shall not condone this.
The statements that were uttered by the Prime Minister were vague, unqualified, illegal, ill thought, and with the intention to commit a felony against the people of Northern Uganda. And the felony in question is conversion. When you have positions of responsibility and authority, and property is given within your reach, and you use it for purposes that were not gazetted for, you would have committed a felony. And indeed, we reiterate that the Prime Minister has committed or intends to commit a felony against the people of Northern Uganda.
The tough-speaking legislators vowed to do everything possible to thwart any attempt of relocating iron sheets from their affirmative action ministry to benefit the people of Karamojong, whose iron sheets were diverted to different areas.
So we want to condemn this in the strongest possible term. And we would like to urge her to withdraw this statement immediately.
Embarrassing as the old Prime Minister would come up and say the iron sheets which were picked from our office under our docket be replaced by again the iron sheets which are meant for Northern Uganda. I come from Kitgum and I border Karamoja. My people are more affected than any other.
They turned against the Ministry of Northern Uganda Affairs and questioned its modus operandi, saying all along they have been requesting for relief iron sheets in vain, while the ministry is seated on thousands of iron sheets in stores.
I personally made a requisition on 29th of June, requesting for 1,000 iron sheets for my affected people in my constituency. And this is the letter. But I did not receive a response. So when I see the head of the institution says, there are iron sheets here, but we have not taken, but we have requested for these things.
The Prime Minister disclosed that the Northern Uganda Affairs Ministry has over 4,500 sheets. This has disappointed legislators and asked their line minister, Grace Freedom Chinyai, to resign if she has failed to deliver relief items to the targeted vulnerable communities in Northern Uganda.
I have written letters. I personally wrote many letters to the minister. I even walked to her office requesting her, asking her, putting down what we are undergoing, especially this time that there is high level of raids and abuses by the Karamojong who are always coming to raid my district.
They have committed to mount pressure on the office of the Prime Minister to ensure that the 4,500 pieces of iron sheets are delivered to Northern Uganda without fail. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.